This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.
California is in the fourth year of a severe drought, but it's right next to the biggest ocean on the planet. Some of our viewers want to know, why aren't they just using that? Hey everyone, Julian here for DNews. California is thirsty. On top of having almost 39 million residents, California grows an unbelievable amount of food, with agriculture being a $36 billion industry in the state. It's more than twice as big as any other state's. And that means that in 2010, the US Geological Survey estimates that California used almost, and I hope you're sitting down for this number, 52 trillion liters of water. That's 142 billion liters a day. But California hasn't been getting the precipitation it needs for the past 4 years, and now they're scrambling for new sources of drinking water. Los Angeles County is offering to buy water from Sacramento Valley farmers. The state is urging people to conserve water and was threatening to fine people during the ice bucket challenge craze. But hello, guys, the Pacific Ocean is like right there. Salt water minus salt equals water. Let's go. Do I have to think of everything? Well, actually, San Diego County had the same idea. They're currently building the biggest desalination plant in the Western Hemisphere to the tune of $1 billion. When it's finished next year, it will make 204 million liters of potable water daily and sell at a dollar for every 616 liters. Wow, we're in the clear, right? No. While it sounds like a lot of cheap water, the opposite is true. The price is 80% higher than San Diego pays for treated water outside the county. And even though this plant is huge, it can only make 10% of the county's needs. And it'll use a lot of energy because it's forcing pressurized water through a membrane to separate the water from the salt in a process called reverse osmosis. It's drought-proof and doesn't rely on recycling a resource we're running out of, but as a practical way to solve California's water woes, it's more of a small puzzle piece than the ultimate solution. To put it in perspective, there are countries where water desalination is crucial. Israel is one such country, and their desalination plants provide 35% of their drinking water, or enough for 2.8 million people. California's population is 5 times the size of Israel's, and the agricultural industry is 32 times bigger. 4 desalination plants may be fine for Israel, but it's not enough for the West Coast. Not by a long shot. California also needs water urgently, so focusing more on conservation and recycling may be a better strategy than building desalination plants that won't come online until at least next year. Like I said, we covered this topic because we got comments asking about it on our other video about California's drought. If you want to check out said video, here it is right down here. And while you're at it, if you have any questions you want us to answer or topics you want us to elaborate on, feel free to tell us in the comments. I'm also on Twitter at jhug00, and until next time, thanks for watching DNews.
This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.